You're expecting me, yes?
Yeah.
Hi. I'm Mike. How are you?
Hi.
You're feeling heat?
Well, now we have heat.
What do you mean?
Sunday morning, got up at 5 o'clock, place is cold. I'm like, okay. Went to the bathroom, touched the heater, cold.
Okay.
Like, okay, no problem. It's 5 o'clock, I have blankets. I went the whole day, no heat. Looked at the thermostat, because we have three thermostats. The thermostat was saying 70 degrees is when it's supposed to come on. So the house is now 69, 68, okay. All day went down to about 60, still didn't cut on. I put the thermostat up to about 75, 80, still didn't cut on. So the whole day Sunday, it was cold, no problem. Monday morning now, it's still cold. I'm like, okay, this is cold, I need to call. I actually called you guys Sunday, but it was after hours.
Okay.
So I called you guys again Monday morning.
Yes.
And spoke to the person, and they said, okay, they're gonna let me know when you could come in.
Okay.
Went to work, because I didn't hear from her, because I figured my son is leaving at 1 o'clock, so I have until 1 o'clock. So I called her back, she goes, oh, I'm sorry I didn't get back to you. And then she called me back and said, someone will be here between 10 and noon today.
Okay.
All making sense to you, right?
Yep.
I'm like, okay. Now, before I left to go to work, I turned the thermostat all the way up, all floors, to 90, whatever the highest is. When I left the house, it was still cold.
Okay.
My son left the house, still cold. Don't know what's going on. I'm actually on YouTube. I'm looking up what's going on.
Okay.
Right now, I'm looking everything, nothing. When I came in Monday from work, I came in the house, and I touched the heater because I'm like, it feels warm, but I have on my coat. I have on an undershirt, a shirt, a sweater, my coat, but I'm coming in from outside.
Yeah.
And I come in, I'm like, well, it's warm, so I'm not thinking anything of it. Plus, I'm carrying groceries. Touch the heater, it's warm. Not hot, but warm.
Okay.
I said, okay, it's warm. Went to touch one in the bathroom. Okay, this is warm. The house is still supposed to be 90, but if it's 90, the house should be sweltering.
It'll never get to 90.
No, but it should be hot, right? Right? Because
I get a normal kind of heating system you have or anything.
Well,
so.
I'm wearing all this clothes, and I left the house since this morning, and it was all 3 at maximum. I'm like, okay, this is interesting. So by the time 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, the heaters are now warmer. I'm like, it got to the point when I was going to bed, I had to put the thermostat back down to like 75 degrees. But I don't know what this is about. I don't know why it stopped working.
Okay.
And this is why I didn't cancel.
Okay. So show me a thermostat that you had cranked all the way up.
Well, I can show you all of them. Well, this is one on this floor.
Okay.
Came down. So this I had cranked it all the way up to the top, right? Because I'm like, it's not working anymore. So usually I keep the house at about 72.
Let's see the boiler or the heat.
Yes.
This thermostat. Yeah, Honeywell. Yo, yo. Okay.
I think the one downstairs, because the one downstairs is the newest one. They put in heat. Even though the door up in here, it's warm.
Okay.
So my big thing is, well, we were okay because the hot water heater, the dryer, and the stove were all working.
Okay.
We just couldn't heat the house. So now I have no idea what happened, but I'm just like, okay, this, it reminds me of, like, it's a TIA. Because you know when we have patients who have those like mini strokes, it's a sign that another stroke is coming. So I'm going, it's winter and it stopped working for more than 24 hours.
Okay, so let's, I understand, I listened very diligently to what you were saying. Okay. So Sunday morning was when you noticed the problem to begin.
Yeah.
Now, I know you have three zones, you have three thermostats,
yeah,
right? So when you had the problem with the first floor, was the second?
Was in bed, so it was on the top floor.
So you were the second floor. The second floor was cold?
The whole house was cold.
The whole house, the basement included as well?
All of them, yes. No heater was on. And that's what's...
And now it's working.
Now everything is working. I'm like, what happened? I didn't do anything different. But this is what scares me. I said, it stopped working for more than 24 hours. It was cold outside. Well, this was down to 70. It wasn't even
Yeah, no, I hear you. Did you happen to look under the front cover and see if there's any error code or anything?
Yes, and it just said whatever that
STA1?
Something one, and it says one was it. When I looked up what one was, it just says on
standby. Yeah.
That's what I figured, standby. So everything should be
so
working.
STA1 was on the display when you had no heat.
Yes.
Okay, so that means that it was not either getting a signal to turn on,
yeah,
or
it couldn't turn on.
There's something internally wrong with it where it just thought it doesn't need to turn on.
Yeah.
So that's a possibility. So those are the...
Well, this is why I said, you know,
so right now, right now, your basement thermostat... It's hot. Put this off. Okay, so how old's the boiler?
Okay. I moved here in 2008, so I think the boiler's maybe 2010.
Is it safe to say the second floor thermostat is not trying to heat the house right now? Well, the basement one, according to this, is on. The first floor, just don't turn anything on or off though. So the first floor right now is trying to do something. The basement is also trying to do something, but the second floor is not getting a signal or is not operating properly. So how old is this boiler, by the way?
Like I said, I moved into this house 2008. I'm thinking maybe 2011. Changed from the oil into this.
Okay. And you haven't really had any repairs or maintenance since then, probably, right? Okay. I'm willing to wager that you have these silver boxes are probably all kaput, because I'm going to do some troubleshooting and diagnosing, but the basement thermostat is trying to do something. The first floor thermostat is trying to do something, but the second floor is not. Right? Okay. So I'm going to go to the basement thermostat. So right now it is like set for 70. It's reading 72, reading 72. We're going to crank that all the way to like the max. Same, no resistance. We'll crank that all the way down.
It's the first time that I got heat in the bathroom upstairs. The one by the bedrooms, because I've never worked until we got gas heat. Now, my issue is that when it's time to heat up the house, they're all at the same level so that they all work. But I kind of feel that, something is flashing.
Yeah. So you have multiple zone valve failures. So what I did was bypass the zone valves that get controlled by the thermostats, and the boiler turns on. Okay. So... Your problem, that's one problem. Hopefully that's the only problem you have.
Well,
but
the other thing is that I kind of think that the basement and the top floor are switched.
That's possible.
I think they're switched because when I used to have it, because downstairs is very, very hot.
Yeah.
So I used to have it lower, but then it wouldn't work for upstairs. So that's why everything is the same.
You know what? You're right, because... Well, actually, probably not, because... I don't know. We can figure that out.
I want it upstairs to be cooler because when I go to sleep, I'm on the blanket.
Second floor. All the way up. No.
You travel with a sidekick?
Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. Not today. No, so that thermostat in the basement is definitely controlling this.
Okay.
Yeah. You got bad zone valves. Sensor, power, low voltage, transformer, vent damper. And spark. Where did spark go? Where did the spark wire go? There it is. All right. Power on. STA-17 self-test, STA-1. Okay, now. Oh, the damper's in the wrong spot. Call for heat. Four, six, seven, and followed by eight. Okay, main valve opens. Main valve's running. Disconnect call for heat. Okay. Now to one, and the circulator turned off. All right, basement zone valve. Yeah, jacked up. Oh, it's spinning out too. Make that a little snug. Beautiful. All right, thank you. Basement zone valve, first floor zone valve, second floor. I can't see. Could have another bad end switch. She's engaged. Temperature's at 180. Let's wait for that to drop down. Boiler temp, 200. Damn, she hot. All right, to accelerate the process, I manually opened basement and first floor, so the only one that's actively calling is the second floor with the closed end switch. 161. Bingo. So let's just close that. Let's close this. Okay. So for second floor end switch is closed. We have ignition.
Beautiful. Let's turn off second floor and then test first floor individually, basement individually. All right. Second floor is off. First floor is now open. There goes that call from the first floor end switch. 156 degrees. Circulator's on. It's waiting for the boiler control to kick on. We'll hear that damper crack open. So the damper needs to be above the diverter. So when the boiler is off, any heat that remains can radiate out through the damper and prevents the draft, you know, the outdoor air from making its way down and out the draft diverter. Helps increase efficiency. Set point is 180. TT is on, so it's got that active call. Beautiful.